Hey YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator course called Illustrator Essentials. You can check it out on bringyourownlaptop.com. If you want to follow along with this video, there's exercise files, okay? Those are free to download. You can go and download those and there'll be a link in the description, okay? So you can play along. One last thing is there's a cheat sheet as well. So there is a PDF you can download from bringyourownlaptop.com. Look for resources, okay? It's a free PDF. You can download it, print it up, stick it next to the computer while you're doing these videos. All right, enjoy the video. Bye now. Hey there, in this tutorial, together, we're gonna make gradients, because gradients are awesome. Let's go and do it now in Illustrator. All right, so working with gradients, we're going to open up our postcard.ai file that's in our exercise files. You don't have to, obviously we can work with any shape. In this document, we're gonna work with this black ground here, and in our layers panel, we locked that layer. So I'm gonna go to layers and I'm gonna unlock it so that I can click on this kind of object in the background here. To add a gradient, let's go to properties and where it says fill, click on that. And let's just get started with one of these. Like there's ugly white and black, and then there's ugly orange to kind of weird other orange, and then there's a sky blue to white. Okay, so you can start with one of these. Just start with the black versus white. To change the colors, the easiest way is probably just with the window gradient panel. Where are you, gradient? There you are. Okay, this panel here, if I move it up this, we can just double click these houses. Okay, so double click the white house, and you can pick a new color from down here. Double click the black house. Well, you can see what I did there. I double clicked not quite on the house, it generated a new swatch for me. Okay, if it does do that, now I've got three swatches, which is kind of cool. It means that I could pick another color. Okay, and have a kind of a third transitional color. It's gonna be bad. Actually not that bad, I like it. But anyway, if you do wanna get rid of one of these, you just click on it and click the little trash can and that'll get rid of it. To edit, just click back on the line underneath. All right, so we've got our gradients. Now we want to adjust the kind of maybe direction. And we use this tool over here, okay? Called the gradient tool, funnily enough. Okay, give it a click and you can see there's my gradient running right through the middle. What I can do is just click, hold and drag anywhere on this rectangle, okay, and change how I've got it. So I'm using a linear gradient. We can go up to linear, change it to radial, and kind of works differently, right? We're kind of drawing from the center out. It's up to you how you want to do it. We can go way past where we need to be. All right, so we're gonna go back to linear, and a couple of things you can do, watch this, is if I hover above this line, I can actually use these houses. Okay, I can double click them here. It's just an alternative for clicking them up here. It doesn't work on all compound shapes and lots of other things, so I find just using the gradient tool is better when you're new. So yeah, we've got our gradients. Now, let's say I taught this course, I've been teaching the Illustrator for a long time, and gradients was something like, for the last 10 years we've been laughing at, like, ha ha ha, gradients. Gradients are so back. And a cool little site that I found the other day is this one here. It's called Gradient, okay? And all it is just nice gradients, okay? Having a look through, there's a few different options. And what's really nice about it is, say that you like one of these, you just click on the start color, okay, copy this number here, it's called the hexadecimal number. I'm gonna click copy and jump into Illustrator. And what I can do is I can click on this house and down here, I can replace it there. Hit return, jump back in, grab this one, grab it properly, copy, paste it, grab you, paste it down here. And you can kind of just borrow gradients from people. Now I'm gonna drag it. You can see my, the reason what's happening with this box here, I'm gonna close this down, is that I've got mine underneath. Okay, you might not like that, but let's say I wanna start my gradient from about here onwards. Okay, there we go. Oh, look at that, I love it. Anyway, so let's look at a couple other things that you might run into trouble with, because a rectangle is pretty easy. Let's look at something like this. So this here is an outline bit of text, okay? So it's not editable text, we've outlined it. Okay, so it's just kind of shapes. The problem with it is when I add it, and I go to here, you'll notice it kind of does it individually, where I want a kind of gradient that goes across all of them. The way to get around that is if you grab your gradient tool and just drag across them all. Okay, you gotta actually grab your gradient tool and drag across them all, it will kind of join them all up. Now we need to open up the gradient panel again, because remember that line that appeared that we could work on the graphic down here? It just doesn't work with compound shapes. So we're gonna go here and we're gonna go to gradient. If you're not sure what a compound shape is, don't worry, we're gonna cover that later in the course as well. I want radial, it's pretty cool. But I'm gonna drag across them all and we get this kind of like, yeah, consistent across all three of them. And I'm gonna pick a color. You can move on now. I am totally just gonna go off and find a cool color and yeah, add it to it. You can skip on to the next video. Oh, I love this. Look at it. Who would have thought I'd love this? If you'd asked me a couple of years ago, Dan, you're gonna be into gradients and they're gonna be kind of like, I don't know, 80s retro pastels, I'll be like, no way. Here we are. Okay, this one's got three colors in it. I'm going to grab a, so I'm clicking on the line there, double click. And then the last one is this green. Now, if you're finding your colors aren't just matching the same as mine, I take it back, I'm not sure. I'm not sure I'm into this color as much as I thought I was. But let's say that you don't, the colors just aren't coming out rich. They're looking really nice in here, but they're washed out in your Illustrator file. It's because you're probably working in CMYK. We covered this a little earlier, but what you might wanna do is before you change the colors, okay, you might go to File, or pick your colors, go to File, Document Color Setup, and make sure you're in RGB. Change it to RGB, then go and add your colors. It's kind of like a one-way street. You can't just flick it over to RGB and hope they come back to life. You need to put them back in now. All right, that is gradients in Illustrator, which I now love, which probably in a year or two, nobody will love again. Ah, gradients, they're so in fashion and then out of fashion. All right, let's get into the next video. Hi there, welcome to this video. We are gonna take images and crop them inside of boxes, inside circles. We're gonna do it in type multiple shapes, okay, and inside text, and the text is editable. Awesome, let's go and learn how to do that now in Adobe Illustrator. So first up, if you're following along with the tutorial series, make sure that you're on your background layer, it's unlocked, and let's just turn the eyeball on the type layer off so we're just working on this one layer. Now, you know you're working on this layer because it's blue. Okay, next thing I wanna do, I'm gonna zoom out a little bit and bring in an image. I'm gonna go to File, I'm gonna go to Place, and we're gonna start with this one called Desk. I'm gonna click Place. This is a very big image, so if I click once, it ends up being this ginormous version. So what we're gonna do is we're going to click and drag it out. Okay, so I'm gonna bring it in, and I'm gonna drag it kind of, it's a bit hard because it's a rectangle, so drag diagonally out, and just make sure it's bigger than what we, you know, this square that we're gonna crop it into. Now with the black arrow, just kind of move it so you roughly get it to the position you want. It's hard to see, I know. And what we need to do is that the gray box needs to be on top. Okay, the shape that you're gonna use is the clipping mask. Okay, it needs to be on top of the image. So I'm gonna click on this guy, go to properties, let's go to arrange, and we're gonna set him to the back. Now I'm gonna get him into a kind of a rough position that I kind of want to clip. We can adjust that afterwards. Now I need to select both of these. So I'm gonna click my rectangle tool first, the gray rectangle, hold shift, grab my image, so they're both selected. Now over here, we've got one that says make clipping mask. Awesome, huh? Okay, so it doesn't really matter what the shape is. Let's do a circle, so an ellipse. Okay, I'm gonna draw a circle. I'm gonna bring in an image. It doesn't really matter if it has a fill or a stroke. Okay, I'm just gonna give it one so you can see it. Let's go to File, Place. There's one called Drawing 2 that we used earlier on. We'll use him again. Again, I'm gonna drag it so it's kind of big enough to go in the circle, get it into a rough sort of position for me. This one needs to be at the back, arrange, send it back, select them both, make clipping mask. So it doesn't really matter, you can draw with stars, pentagons, okay, whatever you wanna draw with. You could draw something custom with the pen tool or the curvature tool. Now there'll be a time where you wanna readjust this image. So remember the black arrow kind of physically moves stuff around, the white arrow gets in there, right? So if I click on there, click off, click back in there. It's click on the image, you can kind of see it's kind of sprung to life, and I can move this around to adjust the size. I actually need to switch back to my black arrow, and it kind of remembers that I've got the image selected. Holding shift, let's say I want to get it perfect in there. Okay, I can still adjust it. So that's how to get in there and adjust them. Let's click off. There'll be times where you need to actually just pull them apart, like come out of there. And it happens if you're opening up somebody else's image and it's clipped and you're like, how do I get it out? Okay, with it selected, there's one over here, it says release mask. Click on that and they just kind of come apart. Now the circle that we had here, remember I can't remember what color we had, it was blue I think, but it's disappeared. It's still there, okay, but it has no fill anymore. That's just something to be noticed. Okay, I'm gonna undo, put it back where it was. Let's look at another way of masking, okay, and it is using multiple shapes. Okay, and there's a little trick you need to do. So I'm gonna draw an ellipse, It doesn't matter what color. Okay, I'm just gonna show you. And I'm going to duplicate this one. A cool way of duplicating, you can copy and paste, okay, but I like to hold down the black arrow and then hold down the option key on a Mac. You can see the cursor changes a little bit, and it's Alt on a PC. So while you're dragging, okay, I'm holding down the option key and you get multiple options. I'm gonna have four of these little guys, and then I'm going to group them so I can make another set. I don't know what I'm doing really, just I guess a for instance. Okay, so I'm gonna use this and I'm gonna bring in an image, so a file place, and one called color bomb, and I'm gonna click place, and I'm gonna drag it so it's kind of covering this whole thing. Okay, now remember it needs to be at the back, arrange, send to back, and then I select them all, and I go make clipping mask, and it doesn't work. Okay, so the trick you need to do first is you need to select everything except the image. So I selected them all, held shift to deselect this back one. Any which way you've got to select all of these guys, and you need to convert it into what's called a compound path. Now we'll cover compound paths properly in the next one, but for you in this case, all we need to do is go object and go to compound path and just go to make. Nothing changes with it, except now when I have them both selected and I go to make clipping mask, hey, they work. Okay, so make it a compound path. That can be any shapes. Like I've just used circles. They can be like a bunch of random shapes or outline text, anything like that. Next thing we wanna do is within text. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn my layers back on and grab my type layer. I want this thing, okay, that I drew earlier. I'm going to just move it up here. I'm on my type layer now. Okay, I'm gonna bring in another image. Okay, I'm using my shortcut now. Okay, I'm getting tired of file place. You can see command, in my case, it's command shift P because I'm on a Mac. It'll be control shift P on a PC. It's one of the common shortcuts. I'm gonna bring in color bomb again. Okay, and what I'm gonna do for this one is I'm gonna drag it quite big out here. I've got a plan, okay, for multiple lines. Anyway, so text is pretty easy, right? All I need to do is make sure he's behind. So properties, arrange, send it back. So there's my text layer, you can't really see him. Doesn't really matter what color he is, I'm just showing you so you can see him. So select them both and then go to make clipping mask. Awesome, huh? Well, you can kind of see it. See the edge there? Okay, the reason I did that is because I want to do this. Because it's editable type, I can double click on it. Okay, and I can go into here and go boom. Anybody else remember that song? I had this on cassette. Kasingle, I think it was called. Loved it. Anyway, so the cool thing about it is I double clicked on it. The weird thing is I ended up going inside the shape, okay? And we looked at this way at the beginning. It's called isolation mode. I've kind of go inside this kind of clipping mask. To get back, I click on this arrow loads of times until it disappears. You can see the image, you know, editable text, the image is there. You can go in and change, say you want to move the image because it's a bit dark up here. Same thing again, double click it to go inside. And then if you kind of move around, you can see I'm selecting the text and over here is the image. Okay, so I've double clicked to go inside, I'm inside this clipping group and now I can move this image around. It's a bit fiddly, I'm not gonna lie to you. So have a little play around with it so you can get it to work. But when you're finished, definitely smash away at this arrow until you're back out. And that is clipping masks with text. We did it with multiple shapes, remember compound path, and just any old shape you like by just using the little option down here. All right, that is masks. I've said that twice. Let's get on to the next video. Hi, what did you think of the video? If you enjoyed it, give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Also leave me a comment, let me know what you liked about it. Also, this is kind of a short part of a longer course. Okay, if you wanna check that out, it's at bringyourownlaptop.com. This is the essentials course. Okay, there is also another course, there is an advanced course, okay, for Illustrator, and also a UI web app design version of Illustrator course as well. Check all those out. Also, it's quite a visual course. I'd love to see what you've actually made. On Instagram, I'm bringyourownlaptop. Okay, check that out. Also, remember there's a cheat sheet you can download. Bring your own laptop. It's free under resources. Check all that out. And yeah, I'll see you in another video. Bye now.